Hello everybody, my name is Edson and welcome back to a brand new episode on the Timeshare SMP. Today I'm going to be doing a few things. I'm going to be talking, but first, these are the kinds of episodes that I don't really do that often, where I just do something and talk over it. But there's been a lot of questions since the information or news has come about that Timeshare is resetting, and I just want to just create a video so that I have a video so people can just come back and just watch this. If anyone asks, I can just go, watch that video, watch episode, whatever this is. But it was my birthday yesterday as I record this, and yes, that means I'm recording this on the actual day that you guys are seeing this. I know I'm a little bit behind, blame just the birthday stuff and things. But Pudsey, while I was streaming on Timeshare for part of the celebration stream that I was doing, Pudsey gave me a few presents. Now, some of the presents involved like this block of diamond, and all of these potions and some cake, and also Sir Buttsworth. So we now have a fifth pig on the Timeshare server. Hopefully this one survives a little bit longer than the last. I would sleep, but I've slept up there, I think. I'm just going to quickly go and double check and sleep up there now, just so I am 100% slept up there. Right, here we go. Awesome. Okay, there we go. Right, so what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to go and show you guys. I've been told that a certain Poopnado and Wynn have stopped by my place and built some form of a cake, I think. What do I have? Feather Fallen? Shall we commit to it? I think I can survive. Ooh! Damn it! I thought I could survive! Oh no! Oh, bad things. Oh god. Oh good. No, 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 no. Oh no. No, 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 no. Damn it! I honestly thought I'd survive. You know what? We can jump onto the wall from there. Oh, that was bad. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about, while I clear that up, whatever that cake is, I'm going to start going to the Nether and trying to mine some quartz. So that's what we're going to be doing. And while I do that, I'm going to speak to you guys about Season 2 of the Timeshare SMP. Let's start from the beginning. Not so long ago, about a month, 2 months ago, something like that, Winter revealed, I think it was Winter that was the first one to reveal. We were basically just waiting on either Wynn or Poet to sort of say anything before anyone else said anything. I think Wynn said in like a public, I think it was like in, damn it. I think Wynn said in a Q&A that Timeshare would be resetting for a Season 2. Now, there is, like, we can't, like, we are not going to be saying when, but just know that Timeshare is resetting sometime soon. So, we're resetting for a Season 2, and that initially bodes loads of questions. Like, first of all, what's happening to the current world? The current world is just, it is what it is. We're just leaving the current world as it is. There'll be a final world download, which will be awesome. There'll be probably like a final tour. Happy birthday from Poet and Wynn. Thank you. There'll be like a final tour that'll go down. There'll be a load of cool stuff that'll happen. And just know that, like, you guys will see in the episodes that the reset is coming. So most of you will be able to guess when the reset sort of is close to happening. Just know that. What does that... So first of all, that is like that's that. The reset's happening. It's coming. We're looking forward to it. Even though some people haven't finished their base, like, or their builds, like Wynn. Wynn hasn't finished a build, which kind of sucks. But there's a lot of... It's hard to tell because it's been a while since we started actually talking. Like, we've been talking about this for a while. just in ourselves on the server and everything. And it's a little bit hard to judge how we actually or how demotivated some people were, because it's hard to actually remember when we actually started talking about this. It's been a while. Is there anything in here? Is this full? Oh my gosh. I need to go and get some stuff. Damn it, BRB. Right. So, yeah. There's a few people that haven't finished things, and there's a few, like, that's why, like when Pudsey joined, oh, please don't die. Like when Pudsey joined, she never really decided to go out and build like a massive base. She just built something at spawn, and then started doing like collaborations and stuff. Like we've known for a while that TimeShot is going to reset, and I think deep down we've known that it's going to be sooner rather than later. I think some people have worked out, but you look at other SMP servers, whether they be huge SMP servers or smaller SMP servers, and we are probably the longest running content creation wise, like a content creation server, like that creates like videos on YouTube that has like so many active members. We're probably the longest running on one set world, so I think it was just only a matter of time really, before the reset was just coming. And yeah, like I am looking forward to it. Am I looking forward to it? Yes. Am I sad to see this place go? I'll be honest, not really. I'm definitely ready for a reset. I feel like the projects that I was moving on to and everything are good. Like the villager farm and all of that. But I don't know, I just feel like a reset was, for me, a reset is definitely something that's needed, especially for myself. Like I've built a lot on this server, a lot, and I've still got a lot still to do. There's like a big to-do list that I'm still working on, and I'm hopefully going to get done before the reset. But yeah, it's definitely a thing that I think I need to spark my motivation again. And I only think my motivation is slightly lacked in a little bit, and because I don't know, deep down I've known that this reset was coming sooner rather than later, and seeing other people demotivated on the server sort of like acts to yourself. And this is always the thing with like server resets and stuff. As soon as you say, oh, the server reset is then, that's it. Nobody does anything like from that point onwards, because they're just like, oh, what's the point? The reset's happening. I didn't see it like that. I saw it as the reset's coming, I need to get some stuff done, sort of thing. So like I finished the villager farm, I've still got this to-do list, and I'm going to be working on that extremely hard to do all of that, and it has motivated me to complete all of these things. When I've done this thing, I've given myself a task of there we go, I've given myself a task of, where is, there they are, I've given myself a task of just going around the server, finding little builds, little things that like are half complete, half done, and finishing all of those things. So that's going to be my task for the rest of season one of TimeShot. So I feel like that's good. I feel like that's good. I've got something to do. But for the people that haven't really got anything like that, or haven't really sort of like decided on what they're doing, have just stopped their build, I think it's. I honestly think it's made a lot of people demotivated, and the more people that get demotivated, the more people see other people get demotivated. It acts sort of like, it then rubs off on them, they get demotivated, and it's like a thing that just spirals out of control. It's quite bad. So yeah, it's been interesting to see just behind the scenes and stuff in recent months. But season two, I honestly think will change that, and it's gonna be a fun time, and I really am looking forward to season two. And answering questions more towards actual, like, what will happen with me on Season 2? What am I going to be doing? So, I've had this question a lot, because I've built quite a few big things here. And I think a lot of people are wondering what I'm actually going to do on Season 2. And I've been asked in my streams multiple times. I've told quite a few people on my streams multiple times. So, there's a couple of tasks that I'm going to set myself in Season 2. Okay. Task number one. When I start, I'm not going to mine up any diamonds. I'm not going to mine up any diamonds. The only diamonds I'm going to mine up are... Where did I put all of this stuff? I don't know where I put all of this stuff. The only time I'm going to mine up diamonds is... Or use diamonds... is if I find... So if I find diamonds in dungeon chests, if I find them as loot in temples, in villagers, anything like that, I'm going to keep them, use them for tools and everything like that. If I find tools in, like, anything else, like, it's basically just... If I get diamonds through any means other than myself mining them up, like, in a mine, I will use them. Every time I see diamonds, I'm going to mine them up with Silk Touch. And then 1 year into Season 2... I'm going to see how many diamonds I have, and I'm going to fortune 3 every single one of them, and just see how many diamonds we have. So every single diamond I find in like a mine or anything is going to be Silk Touched, and it's just going to be kept, stored, saved for later, and then at some point later on, we'll then... Holy crap, does this really like... Is this really just full? I thought it was going to, like, just be hollow. Jeez! so that's one thing that I'm going to be doing. I think that's going to be quite interesting. So, like, and obviously with it being, like, 1.9, I get to start again. And I don't get any diamond armor until I find the diamonds in, like, dungeon chests and stuff. So I think that's going to be quite interesting. And it's going to add, like, a new aspect that's going to make Minecraft a little bit more difficult for me. I'm going to, from the start, I am going to try and not die, which I think will be quite interesting as well. So I'm going to try and not die, and obviously with the fact that I can't, the only diamond armor I could make, and this also teams into what I actually want to do first on the server. So this all like rolls into one sort of thing. So just think of it this way: the only diamond armor I can create is if I find like diamonds in dungeon chests or temples or anything like, or loot chests basically. If I find diamonds in loot chests, I can then make diamond armor or tools. But those diamond armor and tools are going to be quite rare to me because it's taken me a while to craft them, to get them. The reason that I like this is because I actually want to start messing around with villagers straight away. So when I get the armor, I'm going to want to put mending on it. I'm going to want to put all of the best enchants on it so that I do survive and I don't die with the armor and I don't lose it all, which will mean that I get to keep it for longer. So I want to create a massive OP armor tool set, but I'm going to have to get the villagers breeding, and I'm going to have to work on villagers straight away, which is the one task that I sort of like gave up on this season because I knew the reset was coming. So that's going to be my first task. So like my first task on the server, like my first thing that I want to build, apart like excluding the initial like starter house thing that I'll obviously build, is I want to create some form of like villager, like OP emerald gathering system slash OP enchanting system thing. Whether it's like a public farm like I was planning on this season is probably going to be up for debate. I may do it in some form of like a test lab thing underground. I think that's maybe what I'll do. I'm not entirely sure. I may do it above ground. We'll see. It may just be in somehow in my base. I may just move all of the villagers into my base somehow. Have like some one epic house or something. That could be something that we do. But I'm just... Oh my god, this is nearly broke. Good god. It's going to take ages to mine up. That's obviously what I want to do. So that's like my initial task. Like I want to start working with villagers. I want to get some OP farmers. I want to get all of the OP books and stuff, enchanting books that I need to get to create like an OP tool set. I'm going to get them. and I'm going to just start trading, start working on trades straight away. That's going to be my number one task on the server before I build an epic base or anything like that. My number one task is get all of the villagers that the server needs. So that's going to be number one. Number two is obviously I'm going to be saving all my diamonds via the Silk Touch. And in turn, obviously, slowly as I build up my diamond collection quite slowly, like the diamonds that I can actually use, but like in tools and stuff like that, I should be starting to get the books and all of that to enchant all of this stuff, which will be good. And then obviously once I've got all of, like, and while I'm doing all of this, I'm trying not to die. And which will be a lot more difficult because I'll only probably be wearing iron armor for most of it and having iron tools, which will be quite interesting. So those are like the three things. Number one, I don't want to die. I want to see how long I can survive without dying. Number two, I'm not going to mine up any diamonds. All diamonds I'm going to mine up are in Silk Touch. The only diamonds I'm going to allow myself to use up until the year mark on the server, 1 year into the server, is I'm going to are going to be the ones that I find in loot chests. And I'm just going to start straight from the off after I've built my initial house to work on villagers because of this, because I want to obviously have the OP armor and tool set, which I'm going to have to custom enchant because I'm not going to get a one-off enchantment that's just going to have everything on that I want. So yeah, that's that. So that's season two for me. That is what I'm going to be doing on season two. What everyone else is going to be doing on season two, what everyone else is going to be, like, I don't know, like, what everyone else is going to, or how motivated everyone else is going to be, I don't know. I can only really speak for myself on that matter. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. When it happens, I will say now, when it happens, there'll probably be a spike in content. There'll probably be like a week or two where like I upload and stream a hell of a lot of time shot. Is there a place I can, do you reckon I'm good enough to hit that? Probably not. So there'll be a spike in content, there'll be a lot of time shot episodes going up on the first week or two when the server does reset. There'll be a lot of streams happening, in the first week or two when the server resets. And it's just going to be very, what the hell? The chicken just suffocated. Aww. Oh, rip. So yeah, that's something to look forward to, and hopefully you guys are as hyped as I am for season two. It's been a while. There's been and like a big. So a lot of people do say, "Why are you resetting? What's the point?" Right. Think of it this way. Someone. Now I'm not saying this is what's happened with anyone that's joined the server. I should preface that right at the start. But say someone joins the server, right? They join the server, they come on, and they see this world. This huge world. Like, just take the Time Shot world as it is. It's massive, absolutely huge. It's got this huge nether hub, very detailed nether hub that links to all these different places across the world. Huge border, lots, pretty much everything explored, so many things built, so many different things have happened on the server, all the different things. Like, I'm probably the last person to join the, I think, actually, no, maybe Mara, because I know Mara watched a lot of the content. I was probably the last person to join that actually, I think, knows everything that's happened on the server and can sort of, someone can show me something, just like a small, like an abandoned base somewhere, and I can say who built it, when it was, what it was for, and all of that. If someone joins the server now, regardless of how much content they've watched, regardless of anything like that, I guarantee there is something on the server they don't know about. And now, that doesn't sound too bad, but that's just like best case scenario. Someone joins the server now, they walk into spawn, they see this huge world, they don't, like, everything's mined out below them, everything's like being built around them, there's so much stuff happening, and they're just thrown into this world like, go, like, sort of thing. And I know it's not like that, I'm just sort of like using extremes here, but there is like, and if you look at the current members, out of all of the members we have, like 13, 14, however many members we have, It's like a dozen or so, right? However many members we have, look how many of them were there at the very start. There's four. April, Poet, Win, and MK. The only four members that were there from the very start of the server. I know a couple of the members that are here now joined two or three weeks in. But from the very start, the day one, when the server launched, there's four people that are still on the server now. Four people that have been here since the very start. Four people that have seen Spawn develop from what it was. Just this little sort of like opening surrounded by a dark oak forest. Four people have seen that. And every single person that's come and gone or has come and stayed since then hasn't seen that happen. They haven't experienced Time Shot in the way that Poet, Win, April and MK have experienced Time Shot. They haven't experienced the start of a brand new server. But regardless of all of that, we've still created this amazing server with wonderful people, this wonderful world, and it is nice that it's turned into what it has, regardless of how many people are still here from the very start. And yeah, now the server is like closing in on 2.5 years old. Now the server is almost 2.5 years old. The world is 2.5 years old almost. Like, any new member that would join now, it's just so difficult for them to get into the rhythm of things, get into the rhythm of the server and all of that. And there's so many different things that have happened on the server and been built and little things here and there. And everything has its own like story to it. And it's just crazy. It's honestly crazy that we haven't had a reset yet. But it's nice as well. Like, it is nice. Don't get me wrong. It is nice. But it's definitely needed. Like, you look at it like that. Now, when we restart Time Shot, all the members that are there, hopefully, all the members that are there are wanting to be there for the foreseeable future. I would hate to probably see someone join in on Season 2 and then leave, like, 2 weeks in or something like that. But I don't think anyone here at the minute would do that, and I think if anyone was thinking of leaving possibly, if like that was the case, I think everyone in this server is smart enough to know that like with Season 2 around the corner, it would probably be the best time now, sort of thing. I think everyone's definitely that smart. So everyone that's here now and everyone that starts when Season 2 starts is going to be here for a while, hopefully. And it's definitely going to be interesting to see how Spawn develops. It's going to be interesting to see how collaborative we all are in it. Because, like, even to an extent when I joined the server, like, I joined the server and there's just so much happened at Spawn. And I only joined the server, like, 6 months into the server. Something like that. Probably a little bit less, actually. I think it's like about 4 or 5 months, possibly. So, like, I joined the server and I'm like, oh my god, there is a lot of builds here. And I immediately, and just through sheer unluckiness, like, the closest, because I did want to build in a Savannah, I did want to build a Savannah build, because it was new when I joined the server, the whole, like, Savannah thing. And it was just unlucky how far out the Savannah was, but like I knew I had to obviously like move out, sort of thing, like go head out. It'll be interesting to see like when the server starts, how the new Spawn goes, what gets built, all of that good stuff. And it's gonna be so good. It's gonna be so much fun. And now like any new member that does join over the, like, even if a member joins like 2 months into when Time Shot starts, it's going to be so much better than them. Like, joining a server 2 months in is so much better than joining a server 2 years and 8 months in. Like, it's just so much better. So much better. You've got so... Oh my god, hi. I didn't realize you were here. You've just got so much more... Like, you can just grasp everything so much more. And, yeah, the reset, I honestly think, on my beliefs on it, it's long overdue. Not really long overdue, but it's a little bit overdue, I honestly believe. Am I sad to see the world go? Yes. Am I happy that all new any new members that may come when we start season two, and any new members that will come once we've started season two, will be able to join in from the very start and feel involved in everything. I'm very happy with that. That's probably the biggest thing for me. Am I looking forward to the tasks that I've set myself for season two? Kind of and kind of not. I feel like it could go one of two ways. But yeah, I'm just happy with where it's going and everything like that at the minute. And obviously season two, I did say I was going to be going to the Nether, but I thought this was hollow. I thought it'd be a lot less time to clear all of this up. But yeah, that is that. That is this episode of the Time Chest MP. Holy guacamole, what a talk it's been. We've talked for ages. I'm sorry it's been quite a rambly episode, but every so often you just need to do one of these just to talk about a few things and stuff. And the reset, as soon as it was announced, sort of came with it a lot of different questions, and I just needed to answer a lot of them in one video. So now, when the next person asks, what are you doing in season two? What are your thoughts on season two? Why are you resetting Time Check for a second season? When is it happening? All of that good stuff. I can just go watch episode 240 something, whatever this is, of the Time Shell SMP. I answer all your questions in a 25-minute episode. A bit longer than 25 minutes, but it's fine. We won't tell them that. It's false advertising. It's fine. So that's going to be it. I was just thinking I can probably take, because I probably wanted a screenshot of the birthday cake, but it's kind of gone. So I'll probably take like a screenshot, like looking up or something. I don't know. We'll see. So that is me done for this episode of the Time Shell SMP. Thank you for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed this. If you have, make sure you leave it a like. Make sure you leave it a comment. Can you stop going up and down? This is weird. The slime is all glitched. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And as always, I'll speak to you all soon. Take care.